have something. Tasker.
Hello, Master Kratos. What you've accomplished for these realms is... rest assured, good Master Brock would be proud beyond measure, even if only to express it in his love language of profane non-sequiturs. Ah, but he is terribly missed.
Yes, he is.
Now, there is one rather interesting development to apprise you of. The detonation of Asgard shook the world tree to its very roots, dislodging a great number of realm seeds. I thought you might wish to have them. My little way of saying thank you for preventing my death by immolation.
You are welcome. Speak.
The tree has been... And if it grows too wildly, the branches risk getting too heavy and falling, which is not ideal considering they hold all the realms.
I am no gardener.
What an absolute shock. No, I do not require any horticultural skills from you, but I would ask that you keep an eye open for the stags of the four seasons. They normally graze upon the tree and keep it tidy. Unfortunately, Bitter decided it would be funny to trick Arrogant into releasing them. If you happen to find the stags during your travels, I would greatly appreciate assistance in bringing them home. I would have one of my spectral squirrels do it, but they, well, keep eating the feed I give them. Consequence of it being the most delicious food in all the nine realms, I suppose. Speaking of, here, take some feed. Once you've found a stag, the feed should calm them down. Then one of my spectrals will guide them back here. And, don't eat the feed, please.
I will not.
Bitterness asked me if I was too chicken to release them, but I am in fact not chicken-like whatsoever. So as you can see, I had no choice.
Yes, of course. What else could you have done? While normally this would be a harmless prank, Fimbulwinter prevented the stags from returning, and now they have long since scattered to parts unknown.
It was worth it.
Now then, any luck finding those lean worms?
Seems we met another of your detachable emotional apparitions. A bit too twitchy to tell us his name, though.
Ah, you must mean anxiety.
Oh, no.
Why are you talking about me? What did I do?
Oh, you should have heard the shit they were talking.
What? Oh, dear, oh, dear.
There was no such talk. Shame on you, Bitter.
Are you sure?
Yes, Anxious. No opprobrium to be found in this discourse. I was merely making your acquaintance with our adventuring friends here.
Ah, people!
Well, there it is. Well, good luck out there.
Hell of a job you did at Ragnarok, General. Wish I could have been there to see you and Sindri take down Thor and Odin.
Just not what happened.
Yeah, maybe not, but... it's the story I like best. Important thing is... Oh, all right. Yep, okay. Find out what was bothering Helka? Smelled something and just ran right off. Time dead. Leaves him
here. I'll be in the study.
Woo-hoo! Looking good!
It fits.
through the little shop I'm running out in the Alpine Desert, there's something y'all are probably gonna want to see.
Look there. That path wasn't there before, was it?
No.
Might be worth exploring then.
New father, new mother, new fate to suffer. In life we hanged, in death we kneeled, until you freed us with your steel.
Yes.
so destroying the ravens free their spirits somehow. Good to know.
Free?
Well, free of Odin's control, anyway. Hang on a minute. Is this a prison?
It would seem so.
Let's continue. Might be something useful inside. This place goes deep. We should head downward.
Ah, yes. I'm sure there's nothing especially dangerous at the bottom of an Asgardian prison.
Einherjar survived Ragnarok. Perhaps some of the inmates did as well.
Let us find out.
What's the chain do, I wonder?
An elf, but not a particularly high-ranking one. So what did Odin have to gain by imprisoning them?
I'd say information, but why keep them locked up afterward? Why not just kill them? Another chain. Shall we find out what this one does?
Yeah. Can't believe it.
Wait, that can't be. Lord Tyr.
Is this an illusion?
No, brother. No, I think it's the real deal.
Mimir? Is that you, old friend?
In all the important ways, aye.
There was such a commotion. If Odin learns what you've done...
Odin is dead.
The realms are at last free of him. You're safe.
Odin's dead.
And Asgard fallen.
So the reign of the Aesir is truly over. That's quite a lot to take in. And you are?
His name is Kratos.
Kratos? I know that name.
Come. You need real shelter. Food.
No. No, what I need most now, I think, is to reflect on what you've told me. I need space, if you would grant me that.
Very well. Our home is in the realm between realms for the moment. You can find us there when you're ready.
Kratos. I know you from somewhere. I'm sure it will come back to me.
Until then.
I appreciate your concern, but I'm fine. I guess we all are. But I would love to be alone.
You believe that was truly him?
It's hard to trust anything after what we've been through. But with Odin gone, I have no cause to doubt it.
Our paths will cross again. Of that, I'm sure. Where to now?
Well, now we know what this prison's for. This is where Odin stashed those he would camouflage himself as.
Makes sense. If you're going to imitate someone, you wouldn't want them walking around.
Why not kill them?
He must need them alive in order to assume their form.
Aye. Odin likely wanted Tyr dead for a multitude of reasons. But he knew Tyr would be more useful alive.
Your god of war has truly returned. What now?
He'll want to stretch his legs, I imagine. Imprisonment stokes wanderlust. Not that I need to remind any of us of that.